Can you believe that all of that was created by AI simply by typing a prompt? I'm really impressed. Are you? Let's talk about the new Runway Generation 3 Alpha. Before, we could only animate part of the image that was already created. Right now, we can animate the whole image as well as create a video from scratch by typing the prompt. Many creatives use Runway for various purposes, and it looks like a very promising tool for RVs, making the process much easier and more efficient. So let's see what it can do now. In general, there is a difference in how we type the prompt. The more detailed it is, the better and more accurate the results are. I tested three versions based on what I read on their website. The first prompt is very simple. The second one follows the structure I found on their website, which goes like this. Camera movement, establishing scene, additional details. And the last test divides the visual description and camera motion description into separate parts. Let's compare the results. The first one is very random. The camera shows the surroundings, but it's not a shot that will present the building from the best perspective. I would rather set the camera further to show how the building is embedded with context. Lighting also doesn't help the general impression of the space. But the results are not bad in terms of realism. There are issues, but in general, it doesn't look bad. The second one is definitely not a pan movement, and it's not human eye level, as in the prompt. The building is made of wood and glass, which is definitely contemporary. The construction is not very convincing, but anyway, it's more creative than the previous one. In general, the surroundings look better. I like that we show the river behind. The sky is not dramatic at all, but the blue hour works better than the first version of the image. The last one has definitely the pan movement, so at least this is done correctly. We have a nice sky with the sun and lens flares. I like the general feel, it suits the idea I had in mind. But finally, it gets the trees right here, and they actually suit the general color palette, which is cool. The building is more like a bridge, so you wouldn't call it successful. But based on that, you can see that to get nice results, it will require lots of testing and back and forward movement. We can also create custom presets, so if you feel that some prompt works well, you can save it and then reuse it in the next project. We also have an extra option that I think has more sense in RVs. We can use an image as a first or last frame. Thanks to that, we can get more precise effects. I used the exterior shot from our visualization training. You can use your visualizations, or you can even generate an image using AI tools and then try to animate it using this method. The supported size is 1280 by 768. So we have to crop the image first. As I feel that the third option during the tests works the best for camera movement, I will try it here too. So I divide my visual description and the camera movement separately. I want to add movement to people and cars the most, but I also want the camera to move. Let's see what we'll get. Okay, that's interesting. I'm quite impressed, even though it didn't make it exactly as I wanted. There are mistakes too, the cars floating, the flickers and so on. But really, it's just the first version of that tool. Imagine how better it could be in a couple of months or years. It's quite incredible. Let's try one more. This time, I tried the second version of the prompt creation. I want to add the movement of the woman, also the camera movement and the gentle breeze to the image. Also, it would be great if it would add lens flares. It will add a nice effect here. Let's see what we've got. Whoa, in terms of the general feel, it's really similar to what I had in mind. It obviously doesn't work great with people, that's the main issue with both examples. But it worked quite well. If you look at the right-hand side, plants, trees, it really is convincing. I mean, if you need to exactly show some specific areas, it's not great, but imagine how it will make the workflow easier. If your customer wants to suddenly create animation on top of their visualization, it will be easy to show him the style, the atmosphere of the image. You can generate those videos in a couple of minutes and your client can easily see how it might look. Even though the results are not super precise yet, for work in progress videos, it's better than enough. But I can imagine using it instead of stock footage, if it's hard to get the ones you have in mind. There is another option here that can be handy in such a case. We can reuse settings. Here we not only can see what prompt was used or what we used as a frame, but also the settings details. What interests us here is that we can copy a seed of a generated video to get a similar visual style to keep consistency. Now, let's say we want stock footage of the flower to present the mood better. and you want the butterfly flying and sitting on that flower. Let's see the result. That's cool. I like the shallow depth of field and the flares. It will help to explain the modern style of the animation. Great example. It's actually very convincing. I think this is something that we could use instead of stock footage. The resolution is not there yet, but we can use Topaz to fix this. If you want to know how to upscale videos using this software, check out the first video. Also, if you would like to learn how to create beautiful animations, check out our course. Bye bye!